Today we will see experimentation method of teaching physical science, and in this we will talk and we will see about experimentation. What is the experimentation? Why we can do the experimentation? By talking side by side, what are the merits of experimentation? And we will also see what are the process of doing experimentation and what is the limitation of the experimentation method of teaching. And we will see specifically in the two context. One is in the controlled condition within the laboratory and beyond the laboratory situation, means what kind of experimentation we can do in a controlled way and in the laboratory, and what kind of experimentation we can do outside the laboratory. Okay, so these things we will be seeing. So first, when we talk about the experimentation method is a process of teaching where a student have a hands-on experience and exposure to the concept that is being taught. It is a process of providing hands-on experience to the learner. Okay, so in the experimentation process, the major focus is to engage the learner in the learning process by giving them hands-on experience. And always remember, when we talk about the experimentation, we used to see a cause and effect relationship. Cause-effect relationship, you can understand in a way that for some phenomena, there will be some cause. And when the cause is given, what will be the effect? You may not be able to understand the cause and effect. You can understand it in a simple way. Suppose that in a biology, okay, of elementary level, one concept that we were studying, that the leaf and the stem and the branches of a tree used to bend themselves towards the sunlight. And for that, what we were doing, we were keeping a plant planted in a pot in a dark area, and we were covering so that there will be a total dark area and the plant will be in a dark area, and we were allowing an opening, one opening from where the sunlight can come. So after a few days, 4, 5, 6 days, you will find that the branches of a plant and a leaf are bending towards the sunlight to get more sunlight, because for the photosynthesis in the plant, sunlight is a one of the important component that is required. So they used to bend that side. Another example of a plant you can also take, that you plant one plant in a pot, and you make an arrangement in a such a way that in half of the pot there will be a weight, that is will be a water, and in the other side there will be a dry. So you will find after some time, after 10-15 days, that the root of the plant is bending towards the area which have a moisture. Why? Because in order to survive a plant, in order to do a photosynthesis, this water is also one of the important criteria. So in that way, we can understand the cause and effect relationship. The light and the water, that here in the two example I have taken, is a cause. And what kind of effect that cause is giving? That effect is giving that it is allowing of bending of a branches towards the sunlight. It allowing to bend the root towards the moisture. So this is a kind of a cause and effect relationship. And when we will talk little bit deeper, I am going because I am thinking to take more time for this class. So little bit deeper when you will go, you must have heard one word, that is variables. How many of you heard the word variable? Variable समझते हैं variable? कितने लोगों ने सुना है? Can somebody tell me? क्या है variable वो? डिफाइन कर सकते हैं, व्हाट इज द वेरिएबल? एनीबॉडी? नहीं वन करके बोलिए. अच्छा ठीक है, प्रियंका साहब. प्रियंका
सर, चेंजेस सर, कुछ चेंजेस दिखाना.
कुछ चेंजेस दिखाना
मतलब
हम इधर से उधर चेंज हो रहा है तो वेरिएबल है.
सर समथिंग व्हिच इज नॉट कांस्टेंट.
समथिंग व्हिच इज नॉट कांस्टेंट, व्हाट इज दिस समथिंग?
सर मे बी क्वालिटी क्वांटिटी.
क्वालिटी क्वांटिटी,
एनीथिंग दैट इज नॉट कांस्टेंट वेरिएबल.
कैन यू साइट वन एग्जांपल ऑफ वेरिएबल? है ना, मैथमेटिक्स में पढ़ा होगा वेरिएबल एंड नॉन वेरिएबल नंबर्स.
जी सर.
क्या है आपने कभी ये सोचा नहीं कि ये वेरिएबल वेरी क्यों कर जाता है? है ना, जैसे मैथमेटिक्स में हम एक एग्जांपल देते हैं कि कांस्टेंट नंबर है 1 2 3 4 5. ओके, सो सपोज दैट आई एम टेकिंग एग्जांपल ऑफ नंबर 5. सो 5 इज अ 5, इट रिप्रेजेंट्स अ क्वांटिटी 5. है ना, 5 represents a quantity which is 5 times more than a unity, unit, one unit ka 5 times kar denge, that is the 5 number. But when we talk about the variable number like that x, y, z, so x can, sometime it can pose a value of a 2, sometime 5, sometime 8, sometime 1000, sometime crores. It kaise change karta hai, how it changes? See, very briefly I will tell you, I think you will be able to understand that when we talk about the variables, theek hai na, isko aap yaad rakhiye, because in every batch I used to ask the question, what is variable, which is very basic and fundamental in nature, and people fail to answer. Theek hai, sometimes people understand but they fail to explain, express. So, when we talk about the variable, then the concept of cause and effect relationship comes. When we talk about the variable, then the cause and effect relationship comes. And cause is non-variable number and effect is the variable number. Kaise? Understand with one example, then I will come to the experimentation. Suppose that you have a planted two, kya karenge? Two rose plant, hai na? Do rose plant ko lagaya, which is of a same breed, which have a same height, same age, everything is the same. I have planted in a two pot. Here one pot, here one pot. Dono pot mein I have planted a rose plant. Then what will happen? Suppose that in one plant I am only putting some water, regularly I am putting the water. Okay. And I have kept in both the plant, I have kept in the same place, so that sunlight will be also available equally to both the plant, and the environment will be also be same for the both plant. But in one plant only I am putting a water, and as and when a time is required I am doing some nursery work to the plant also. It is a very common, hai na? So, that I am doing. then in the other plant I am also putting the same amount of water. Suppose that in this water I have put 100 ml of water per day, so here also I am putting 100 ml of water. But what I am doing, I am putting a fertilizers also, hai na, I am putting fertilizer also in the second one. After some time you will find that in plant A, suppose that this is the plant A and this is the plant B. So in the plant A, after 15 days, 5 rose is coming, rose flower. But in the plant B, you will find ki more than 5 roses are coming. Isn't it? More than 5 roses are coming. And the rose, the amount of a rose will increase if I will increase slightly the fertilizers. Slightly, not I am saying too much, slightly I will increase the fertilizers, so it will become more healthy and it will produce more flowers. But if I will start putting again more fertilizer, then the plant may die also. So what is giving the effect of variable number of amount of a flower? That is the cause which making the number of a flower to vary. Thoda sa dalenge, then more flower you can get. But if you will put more, then it will die also. That is also an effect. So whenever the concept of a variable comes, then it comes the concept of a cause and effect. Because unless or until there is a no cause, then there will be no variability will be seen. Variability will be never be seen unless or until there is a cause. And that is the concept of a variable in the mathematics too. When you will find there is a equation, and suppose that 2x plus 3y equal to 6, and another equation is that 5x plus 7y equal to 10. Then you have to find the value of x and y. Then there is another set of equation. Then there also you are supposed to find the value of x and y. You will find in the both cases the value of x and y is coming different. And that's why we can say that x is a variable which can vary based upon the situation. It can pose any value. It can get any value based upon any situation, and the situation is the equation, set of equation that you have. That is the set of equation is a cause which is making to vary the value of x and y. Now come to the experimentation. So experimentation is a process where student get hands-on experience to understand the scientific phenomena. Together with they see the cause and effect relationship between the different component of a phenomena. Hana? They used to see the cause and effect relationship. Cause and effect relationship illustration and the hands-on experience is not possible in the other method of teaching. So here they used to see the cause and effect relationship. Then another question comes that what is the experimentation under the controlled condition and experimentation beyond the laboratory situation, which is not controlled one. Controlled and not controlled conditions mein what are the experimentation. Now take two examples. Suppose that in one example I am doing a experiment. Experiment, very simple experiment, I will take one experiment to calculate the value of small g, acceleration due to gravity. I wanted to calculate what is the value of acceleration due to gravity at this place here where I am sitting. What is the value? Because we know that it can vary based upon the location and a position and a location. I want to know what is the value of acceleration due to gravity. So I started doing this experiment in the open field. I went outside the classroom, outside the laboratory, and in the field I am doing. And how we are doing? We are tying a thread to a bob, and then we are shaking, and we are counting a time period. And by counting the time period, we are repeating, and by using the formula, we are calculating the value of small g. But the value of a small g calculated in the open field will not be accurate. Will it be? No. Why it won't be accurate? Because in the open field, there will be air pressure and the speed of air also. Suppose that I am allowing a bob to swing in this area like this, and the air is also blowing in this area. So when it will go in this direction, it will be supported by the air. So it will go little bit far. But when it will retract, then air direction is this way. So it will be opposed by the air, and then it will travel a less distance. So the value calculated there will not be accurate, because the simple harmonic motion that the bob is traveling will not be perfect. So what is required to do here? Here we have to do an experiment where there is a less interference of air speed and waves. There is a less interfere. If more interfere, then accuracy will be questioned. So as far as possible, we will reduce the effect of those things, so that the only the measure of the simple harmonic motion of a bob can be tracked. So if you are doing this type of experimentation, then a controlled laboratory situation is required. You must have seen, I think sometime you must have went to the jeweler's shop. Jeweler shop mein gaye hain aap log kabhi? Swaranjali, have you went to the jeweler shop?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when you are purchasing some item, of a, suppose that gold item, okay, gold item you are purchasing. So how they are weighing the gold item, hai na? When we go to the vegetable shop, so vegetable shop mein kya karte hain? If you are purchasing potato or a tomato or a brinjal or a whatever, so simply they will take some vessel and they will put on the weighing scale and they will measure. हाँ, ये 1 केजी हो गया, 1.5 केजी हो गया, हाफ केजी हो गया. बट रिमेंबर दैट इज नॉट अ वेरी मच एक्यूरेट. समटाइम दे कैन गिव 5 और 10 ग्राम लेस, समटाइम 5 और 100 ग्राम और 50 ग्राम इट विल बी मोर, है ना. एंड व्हेन यू विल ब्रिंग दोस थिंग एंड यू विल वेट इन योर होम, इट मे इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज. Because those commodity are not very costly, so 5-10 gram mein there is a no harm. And in the vegetable shops, there is a lot of inference of airs, hai na? They don't wait to stop the air, and air will not stop outside the house. But when you will go to the jeweler's shop, they will not weigh as the vegetables are. Vegetable shopkeepers are weighing. They will put, they will keep the plate where they will put the jewelry. It will be cleaned, पूरा क्लीन सो दैट द अननेसेसरी इंटरफेरेंस विल नॉट कम एंड दे विल कवर इट एंड आफ्टर कवरिंग दे विल टेक द रीडिंग बिकॉज इफ वन और टू ग्राम मोर और लेस इट विल बी देन इट विल बी अ कॉस्टली अफेयर यू विल ऑल्सो नॉट लाइक टू टेक वन ग्राम लेस इवन द कॉस्ट ऑफ वन ग्राम इज अ वेरी मच हाई सो यू कैन लिंक दिस एग्जाम्पल विथ अ कंट्रोल्ड कंडीशन एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन है ना एंड द वेगिंग दैट वी आर डूइंग द वेजिटेबल्स ऑफ दे आर इन अनकंट्रोल्ड आउट ऑफ द लैबोरेटरी सिचुएशन ओके सो दिस इज द एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन इन laboratory situation, controlled laboratory situation and the uncontrolled laboratory situation. Okay, I think you are able to understand what is the controlled laboratory situation and what are the uncontrolled laboratory situation. So, now come to the definition, the formal definition that controlled laboratory condition of experimentation is a way to control the effect of extraneous variables the effect of or in easy language you can understand effect of unnecessary affecting factors that can affect that can dilute the experimentation so experimentation under the controlled laboratory condition is a process of controlling the condition which can affect the process of experimentation that is the controlled laboratory experimentation and out of the laboratory experiments are the experiment which requires natural setup to happen the phenomena sometime the natural setup is also required I will give one example for that also so when the natural setup is required or the effect of other factors are not much then we perform the experimentation out of the laboratory condition like that one example I have given that when we are purchasing a vegetable suppose that tomato we are purchasing so if 5 or 10 gram will be more it will not affect much so this is the one situation that's why we can weigh in the out of the laboratory condition but in case of a gold if 1 gram it will even a half gram if it is a more then the cost will be much so it is weighed in the controlled condition by covering it and you can also imagine suppose that you are purchasing a onion okay so nowadays onion is a 30 rupees per kg in Bhubaneswar last Friday I purchased 25 to 30 rupees per kg onions are available so now when you will purchase a onion they will not care much and they will give 5 or 10 gram more but when the onion was 150 and last year 150 rupees per kg it went and then when you will purchase an onion they won't give 5 or 10 gram more they will try to accurately weigh the onion so this is the one condition another condition that you can understand with the example when it requires a natural setup isn't it for suppose that example you are experimenting that how much a vehicle or a car can go where the frictions are more hai na so you have to do this experimentation in the natural setup so that you will find a natural road you will find a natural air pressure and all those things naturally happening and in this condition you will see that how much a car is traveling in 1 liter so that you can measure the efficiency of a engine, car engine. You cannot do this in the laboratory condition, because suppose that in the laboratory condition I have started the engine and the wheels are moving without any friction and all those things in a very ideal condition. So whatever the reading we will be getting, that will different from the actual situation. And that's why you will find that when you will purchase any vehicle, they used to write that their mileage, that how much the vehicle will go in 1 liter of a fuel. They used to write with the air strike that in a laboratory condition, not in the real condition. Real condition mileage will be known by the mechanics. Mechanic will say what will be the real condition mileage. So when the natural setup is required, then we are doing out of the laboratory, or there is a no chance of much interference of the other affecting factors, then we are doing a experimentation out of the laboratory controlled condition. Okay, that was the two aspect. Now the point comes that what are the merit of experimentation, experimental method of teaching? Because if we are thinking of implementing experimentation method of teaching, so obviously it will require a lot of resources, lot of effort, isn't it? Because you have to set up all the things, so lot of resources and lot of effort is required. So there must be a benefit of it. Why we should do? Then the first and foremost benefit is, in this process the student gets a hands-on experience. So if the student are getting the hands-on experience, and we already know from the Edgar Dale cone of experience, that if the student have opportunity to do, manipulate and observe the phenomena, then the learning will be more fruitful and more meaningful. So since here the students are getting a hands-on experience, that's why here the student can be getting a more meaningful learning. Okay, that is the one thing. The next thing is that here, since the students are doing a hands-on experience, they are having, so students are the active participant in the learning process. Active participant. So it is as per the constructivism, active participation of a learner can be ensured. And then they also get opportunity for observation. And side by side, you can also observe their behaviors. You can also observe. So you can get more knowledge about the student difficulty, experience and the strength. The next is that here student also get opportunity to analyze, synthesize and come to a conclusion out of the work. So they also get opportunity for analysis of a data, they get the exemplification and all those things. And more and less, it also helps student to link the learning with the real life setup, so that they will think that it is not a hypothetical one. Someone came and written in the textbook, this is a hypothetical. No, they will see how the concept works. If I will say that the value of acceleration due to gravity is 9.1 meter per second, then you will think, why I will believe? How came you know? Then you can show that this is the 9.8 meter per second. Okay, then Since here the students are getting the opportunity to analyze, synthesize, and come to a conclusion, so it develops the higher order thinking among the learners. It develops the higher order thinking because they are involved in the analysis, synthesis, even the recording of the data, calculating the data, and drawing a conclusion. So it leads to develop the higher order thinking. And not only the cognitive part, it also helps in the social development and the emotional development. Because here, suppose that there is an experimentation, so most of the time, the student will be working in a group. So they will learn how to work in a group. The social dynamics they will learn, how to behave, how to talk, how to collaborate, and how to act in a difficult situation that will lead themselves to behave in a emotional backdrop situation. So the point is that here the student get a variety of opportunity when it is coming to a experimentation method of teaching. However, there is some limitation of this method also. The limitations are that when we think of using experimentation method as one of the method of teaching, then we have to have a very rich resource, not only the physical resource, even the rich human resource, a capable teacher, a trained teacher who can engage the learner in the learning situation, who can effectively engage the learner in the learning situation, monitor, guide, and assess them. Isn't it? Because teaching in an experimentation situation requires a different set of a capability on the part of a teacher. Isn't it? So this is the challenge on the part of experimentation also.